Hello everybody, this is David Anton. We are here in the final of the World School Chess Championship that it's been played here in Dubai. As you can see, they are playing in the playing venue that the World Championship match has been played between Magnus and Nepo. And the game already started. Let's first introduce the two schools that they are playing the final. First one is the Saco Liberos from Peru, from Lima, if I'm not wrong. And the second one is the team from India, the Belamal Nexus, who is the clear favorite with so many young good players as Buques, Prague, Mendoca. This team is clearly the favorite too.
And before entering the commentary, hello everyone. I'm Women International Master Lila Fuentes. We need to make a quick change here because we have David Anton here.
Yeah, let's change the name because I'm obviously not Pepe Cuenca, as you can see. So just this little change. And I guess
we are back. All great. See you all.
Thank you, Lily. And we can start with the games that they already started, as you can see. First to mention that we also have a match in the third and fourth position between two Mongolian teams. But we will focus in this final between, as I mentioned, India and Peru. So let's check first game of Buques between Buques against Diego Alexander Reyes, d4, d5, e6, normal Queen's Gambit, c3, and c5. As we can see, these guys are very well prepared, were one of the most played lines now nowadays in the top level, the c5. And Buques tried to avoid the main line that start with c takes d5. And here Black is playing c takes d4, and this line that has been played by many GMs, the top level. And instead of this, he played e3, that it's a move I really like, and I also played, just keeping the tension in the center. Take on d4, takes d4, knight c6, and a3. Well, so far, everything is normal. I think, it was not updated, so. Follow the bishop e7. I don't know if this is already a mistake. Maybe it's interesting to take on c4 because, as we can see, after bishop e7, c5, white has got some space on the queen side. It's going to play, white is going to play b4. And I already like the position for white. Let's see how it continues. Castle, bishop d3. If b4, probably Black can play knight e4, taking this square, so bishop d3 first to avoid this idea. b6, b4, he takes. Maybe it was interesting to take with this pawn, this e5 idea. I understand Lucas didn't want to go for this line because e5 seems very scary, but white can just play bishop b5 and it's winning a pawn, no? Because next move is gonna be bishop takes c6 and knight takes c5, winning the e5 pawn. So maybe this d takes c5 was a better idea. Still, b takes c5 seems still a better position for white because this passed pawn is very strong. Black cannot react with e5. So it seems Buques has everything under control. Rook b8, normal move. I don't know if this is a good move because the bishop is gonna go to f4, so maybe the rook has to go back at some point. Buques plays just castle, and now let's knight a5, bishop f4, and the position seems like really good for Buques now. All the pieces are very well located. As I mentioned before, now the rook on b8 is under attack. I don't know what's the move here for Black, because it seems that the rook doesn't have a good square. on the d5. I don't know if maybe b3 or b2, but it's very easy to attack the rook in that square, so I don't think that's an idea. And yeah, actually Diego goes for rook a8, which is of course a good move you don't want to play, but the leader was not a better square for the rook. Big advantage already for Rukes. We'll see later how the game develops, but White is doing very well here. I think Diego will have to fight very well to keep this game alive. Let's continue with Prague game against Katia Fume Bravo. It was a Sicilian, knight f3, e6, d4, takes, e6, the Paulsen, bishop d3, bishop c5, one of the main lines. Knight b3, here black can go to a7 or e7, but most are logical and playable. He went for bishop a7, castle, knight e7, normal development, b2. White wants to play bishop b3, usually in this line, as we can see, knight c6, bishop b3, changing the this bishop, takes, castle, and knight c3. After the exchange of the bishops, now the d6 square can be a bit quicker, but black can play with d6, queen c7, rook d8, and should be okay. So I think it's normal position for black so far. B5 was played, a4. I think this is more or less normal. No, b4, knight b1. I guess also knight d2 was interesting, but I understand Bravo's idea to play knight b1 in order to play knight d2 and go to the knight to c4, as he did, if I'm not wrong. Knight b1, queen c7, knight d2, and black played bishop b7. Now white can maybe play some a5. With the idea of put the knight on c4, and then the b6 square is gonna be really good for this knight. I think if white plays a5, maybe can get a good position. Also, I guess that idea is to react with d5, no, avoiding this knight c4. If the knight gets to b6, I think definitely white is much better. But after d5, probably black is doing okay. I still prefer white pieces. I think this knight has a good square, the c5 square. B6 is difficult to get, but also can be a weakness. So yeah, I would say white is gonna be always a bit better in this position. I think this can be a very good game for the team of Zach Oliveros to win and maybe fight for the title. He played knight c4, that also very normal move. I like it. Now we have to see now what's the idea against d5. I see the idea now. The idea, I think, is knight b6 and d4, and seems very strong because knight d4, queen takes b6, winning. It is knight takes a8 attacking the queen, so d takes c3 is respond by knight takes c7 winning the game. So probably this knight c4 is even better than the a5 I mentioned, so very well played by Katia Fume. And yeah, d5 is played by Prague, and probably we'll see now knight b6. And instead of d4, I guess black can play rook d8. And well, normal position, as I said, a bit better for white, but not so much. I have the chat here. You have some questions. I apologize for my level of English. It's not perfect, but I'll try my best in this broadcast. Let's see the other games we have here with the white pieces. Leon Luque Mendonca, against Steven Rojas. Knight f3, d5, e3, knight f6, c4, d6, normal idea, b3, avoiding the main line with knight c3 or d4, bishop b7, bishop b2, normal development, castle, knight c3, c5, takes, and here he takes d5, it's normal move, of course, but knight takes d5 is most played. I think black is doing better taking with the knight here. And the most dangerous line for black are with queen c2, with the idea of h4 and knight g5. There are some games with this position, and I can say black has to be really careful. I remember a game between Karjakin and Anand, if I'm not wrong, where white won, I think. So, maybe that's the reason Steven took with the pawn. But after d4, white position is a bit better because he's gonna get an isolated pawn on d5. He took, knight takes, and we get this position that is a bit better for white. White got everything he wanted. Have some noise here. I'm commenting from the Spanish pavilion. I think we have some artists here doing some dance or something. And I don't know if you can hear it. I hope it doesn't take that long, but we'll see. Continue with this game. He played knight c6, bishop b2, bishop b6. Queen d7, takes, and knight. You can see I probably white is going to play knight a4, rook c1, and definitely white is much better, no? I think Leon is playing very well this game, normal moves, and black position is already difficult to play. You know, white's plan, as I said, is just rook c1, knight a4, taking control of the c5 square. And definitely it's an annoying position for black. So good news for the Indian team in this game. I think with white they are pressing quite hard. And let's see this game that seems completely chaos. E4, E5, knight f3, knight c6, c3. We have the Poncioni variation that it's been a long time I don't see it. And well, an attempt to avoid the main lines again, and well, we'll say knight f6. The other move, it's very normal, is d5, fighting for the center, taking advantage of this c3. But knight f6 is also a main option. d4, this is the idea. It takes d4, e5, knight e4. And queen e2. I'm not familiar with this line, to be honest, but it seems that black is also not familiar with the position, because this looks a bit strange for me, this way to play. That's why I prefer, instead of knight d6, this d5, because it's easier to play. I think the only problem with this d5 is queen e4. After that, black can play just f6. And I think it's a very easy development for black. About this line, I'm not sure, as I said. Takes e5, knight e4, queen e2. F5 seems to be the only move. It takes d5. Maybe this is all preparation by Pranav, but to be honest, I don't know it. Knight takes d4, knight takes, c takes, and king f7. Well, it is clear that black wants to develop all the pieces quickly. He wants to play bishop b4, rook b8, and white, of course, has the problem that he didn't develop this bishop, and a rook on e8 is going to be really, really dangerous. So take g7, bishop b4, and white is thinking. Very difficult moment for white here. I think black plays is much easier, no? It's just rook e8 coming, and maybe white is under some trouble here. If something goes to D2, there's rook E8, and I cannot see how white can escape from this. And knight C3 is the continuation of the endgame. I guess the idea is after this, you can take and promote a knight, which is check. So I guess the idea is rook E8. And after rook E8, you have this check, queen F3, defending the C3 square. And after king D7, just bishop B2, and it seems you are on time to castle. So this is crucial moment here. If Diego Saúl can find this knight C3, followed by queen F3 and bishop B2, I think he can get a good position. But he's thinking a lot. I think that's good, because it is a key moment. And we'll see, but very important moment in this game for the match. Let's see the last game of the match between Henry Richard and Rindilla. Sicilian with D6, bishop B5, a very solid line, avoiding the open Sicilian with D4. Bishop D7, takes, castle, Norman Fc6, rook E1. The other plan here is to play with c4, knight c3, and d4, and he decided to go for rook e1 and c3 d4. That is the other main line. Knight f6, d4, takes, d5. Black has to play d5 in order to avoid d5. e5 and knight d4. This is the main line. Knight bd2, takes, bishop b4. e3, bishop takes, queen takes, castle, and we get this position that it is a very normal position. White has a bit more space with this pawn, but black is very solid and he can just fight in the c5 with the rooks. And white play rook c1, rook c8, and rook c3. This is a very good square for the rook, as it is defended, and also the rook can go to the king side sometimes, no? After playing some knight g5, maybe rook g3, rook h3, and white has some attack in the king side, so black should be a bit careful, but I think they can play just with knight d7, then I can go to defend f5, exchanging rooks on the c5, and black should be completely fine. So, yeah, not happening that much here. He played b6 and b4. This can be a mistake. I don't like this move, because now the c4 square is weaker and the rook is not very well defended. It's true that a knight cannot get to c4 easily, but still, I think just after knight e7, try to exchange things on the c5. I think white has black has very good chances. Yeah, I prefer black here. Let's go back to the first game, to Rook's game. He was doing very well here after rook A. He played knight b5, trying to kind of to win immediately. No, bishop c7 is the main threat, threatening the queen and the knight. Knight c6 back, rook b1, normal move, a6, and he went back to c3. Maybe knight d6 was also good, but I think knight c3 also cannot be bad. Now white has won the d6 square, that a rook can go here, also the knight. Knight h5, I like this move, because this bishop is very strong on f4, so it's good to put it under pressure. Bishop e3, because of course white would like to have the pawn h3 to play bishop h2, but he didn't have time to play, so he has to go to e3, and g6. Well, trying to defend the knight to avoid again this bishop f4, because it is normal, knight a4. As I said, the b6 square is not weak, so it makes sense to take advantage of it. Bishop f6, and knight b6, rook b8, and g4. Logical move. Also, the knight has go to d7, where it's practically useless. No squares for this knight. And now bishop f4, again, very normal move, attacking the rook, and again putting the bishop in the best diagonal. No? The bishop can go sometimes also to d6. Black play rook b7. Bishop a6, and it seems that white is completely winning now, right? Like it's winning material, takes, and it is an exchange up and a pawn. Yeah, I think Gukes is going to win this game, 100% sure. So good news for the Indian team, for Belamal Nexus, that I think Gukes is not going to forgive his opponent here. Yeah, let's see Prague games. D6, we left the game here, takes. This looks like good news for Black, as they changed this important knight on B6, and they got some activity with the rook. So we played by Black, bishop B4, rook H5, threatening mate, queen E3. I don't like this exchange. I think maybe white has just to go for h3 and try to take advantage that the white queen, I think it's a bit better and has good control of the center and of the black square, so the knight can jump. But okay, this queen d3, it's also not my move. Takes, knight d4, smart move by Prague, a very dangerous idea. After bishop b7, knight b2 mate, no? It's a very nice idea. So, it creates some problem for white. Got to play rook e1, that seems a very normal move, no? Avoiding knight e2 and defending the bishop. And after takes and bishop d5, I think Prague is very happy with this position. We're gonna get a rook ending with this pawns here on b2 and b3 that can be really weak, especially this b3 pawn when a rook gets to d3. Yeah, it seems that Prague is gonna put some pressure in this endgame. I don't know if he will win, but definitely it's good news for him, because I don't think he can lose this game. And his team is doing very well with the white pieces, so yeah, definitely good news for the Indian team. Let's see the game of Leon Luca, who's doing well after rook c1, rook c8, and knight a4. As I said, the idea to keep the control of the c5 square, knight e4. We can see that c5 is not an easy move to make, because bishop f6 is coming, and if black takes with the bishop, the c5 pawn is hanging. And if black takes with the d1, of course the king is gonna be really weak. Probably some ideas with the bishop b3 or even bishop h6 when a tempo, and the queen can go to the king side, seems a bit dangerous. Of course, this is not what you want with black. So Steven tried to play more actively with knight e4, covering the c5 square, but the thing is that this knight has to go back very quickly, no? So he played bishop a6, probably f3 was already a good move, but bishop a6 is very normal, c7, and bishop e5, a smart move, the rook has...
Hi, I'm back again to try to fix the mix, indeed, okay. It's...
Yeah, we're having some...
We will try to fix it. Then maybe we will change the microphone. Maybe this one is better. We will try this one for a bit, and then I will be back if it's still not better.
Okay, thank you.
Bye.
Yeah, we're having some technical issues with the sound. So I hope everything is fine now. And as I was saying, bishop e5 is a smart move, because the rook has no moves at all, so bishop d6 has to be played, and the exchange of the of the black square is obviously usually good for white, as the c5 square is gonna be even more quicker. So bishop d6, takes, and now queen takes was played, and now as I said, probably the idea is just to play f3, putting that knight under pressure, and after knight f6, just take control of the c5 square with knight c5 or even queen d4 first. Both moves are fine, and after knight c5, queen d4, you get everything you want in this line. Then of course it is not easy to win this position. You have to improve carefully. Probably after queen d4, you can play b4, some rook c3, double on the c file, put some pressure. At some points you can maybe, after playing b4, move this knight from d3 to put pressure on c6, on e5, and all the pieces attack the c6 pawn. This is more or less a guide of how to play this kind of positions. And let's see how Leon proceeds in this game. Still thinking. So we can go to the next game. Ranaf, I think many things happen here. Let's see. He played bishop d2, but I think it's not the first move. Rook e8, and as I said now, White is in trouble. Yeah, pity he didn't find this knight c3, but he was, I think, a very good move. And now I think White is much worse. The computer said knight takes x2, winning immediately, but I think it's not an easy move. He played knight d6, just winning the queen, that seems very normal. And I think Black is just almost winning. Knight c3, knight f5. Well, the queen is just doomed, so you can take it now or later. Castle, rook takes, bishop takes, e5, e3, knight takes d7, b1, c6. Well, black has a queen for a rook and a bishop, so it's an advantage of material. And also this plan of b5 is very annoying, as I think it happened in the game. B3, B5, Bishop C1, and A4. White king is very, very weak, especially when you don't have a queen and your opponent has a queen. This is really a problem. Now also the bishop is entering on F5. So, yeah, very, very bad position for white. I hope Diego can put some fight here, but I think it's gonna be really difficult. And again, good news for the Indian team that seems on his way to win this final. He played b4, trying to avoid the opening of the a file, and after a3, king c2. Well, interesting idea. I like the bishop. The king on b3 is gonna be more or less safe. Not completely, but I think it's better on b3 than on a1. We'll see. Of course, white is still lost, but I like this idea by the. See the last board. Well, it happened what we mentioned, a massive exchange on the c file, and now black can choose between changing queens or just try to play for a win, maybe with queen e4. I think definitely here Henry Richard needs to play for a win, because his team is not doing well. So I would like him to keep the queens. Still, even with the queen exchange, a position like queen c6 maybe can be interesting, because the end game is not at all for sure, because black can play with f6, also some ideas here. If white plays b5, some knight a5, knight c4, and it is also interesting. So I hope here there is a game and black can try something, because the Sacco Liberos team really needs a victory in this board. I think Lucas won already, if I'm not wrong. Yes, so first victory for the Indian team, as we saw before, he was completely winning. We can go back to Lucas' game, no, to Prague game, sorry. He's putting some pressure on here on A4. But still, I think it should be more or less easy draw for white, even if black takes, let's say, some G4. If you take here, just takes and rook E4, taking the pawn back after B3, and it's completely draw. So I think this game should be just a draw. That's what I think happened. He played rook C1. I don't like this move because, as I said, there was no threat. Now he just gave the pawn, but still I think should be easy to have this one rook c4. Like maybe black can try to keep the pawn with b3. But yeah, still I think white should be able to hold. Yeah, I'm sorry for this microphone problem. I think we're having some unexpected things here in the Spanish pavilion that we didn't expect. So yeah, it's not up to me, I cannot do too much. So let's just try to focus on the game and on the board. If you play rook e4, rook b8, b3, rook a8, yeah, this was, I think b3 was better try to, b3 it was just losing because they can rook c8 mate. I didn't realize this was mate. I thought the pawn was on h6 or g6, so yeah, I think white is taking the pawn back. The game was rook b8, b3, if black goes to b3, again rook takes b4 is taking the pawn because this is mate. So he wants to a8, and after rook c4, he's just taking back the pawn, and we'll see a draw in this game, probably. We have here the position we saw before, means b2, maybe avoiding c5, but it's a b3, I guess. So similar idea, he got control of the c5 square. I like more this square for the knight, but he can always play. Actually, he did it already, 25-24, and now the knight is the one that is going to c5. And as he said, then probably the plan is to play b4, a3, rook c3, rook ac1, and pressure the c5 pawn at some point. This game going a bit slow. I think the only problem with white is the time. Just 3 minutes for Leon, so he needs to be careful with that. It's an easy game to play, but still, time is gonna be a problem. Yeah, let's get back to this game. I think black is completely winning now. Queen d6, good idea by Pranav, threatening bishop c2 mate. Yeah, we played rook c1 and bishop d3, and yeah, black is completely winning. Team is very weak. Queen up, rook and bishop are not enough to stop this. This queen of made the white skin, so yeah, not so much to do here for the Peru team. They all seems to be completely lost. So far it's gonna be, I think, the victory here. So for victory for the Indian team, this is gonna be. Well, I don't know how he managed to. To take rook b3 before, he got this 4-3. Well, then that is gonna, it's gonna put this still, of course, and draw this rook ending. But yeah, now he has to defend, and it's not that easy. I just got to to hold it, but yeah, still not sure. So we have two victories, probably a draw here for the Indian team, that they secured the 2 points and a half, the tie at least. And very good position here for Leon, but maybe he can get low on time, and maybe Steven can try to put some tricks to try to fight the game. And here, well, I like Kenneth Richard try to get some space on the inside, or probably it's not a good idea, but I think he knew he needs to win the game for the team, so well, trying his best, no? Yeah, now some squares are weak, of course g6, these knights can go here, but also if the knight goes here, then d4 is gonna be weaker, and maybe black can play just queen c6, and after the queen exchange, d4 is hanging. So yeah, as I said, try something. I like it here. I hope Peru can get maybe a victory here, and we can get a more exciting match, because yeah, so far it seems just a one-sided match for India. Actually, he played king f1, that seems to be a mistake. Now queen b5 check seems very strong, and suddenly the queen is creating some problems, probably followed by a5 and knight c6, and maybe black is much better. Yeah, this king f1 was definitely not a good move. I think black quite just wait, maybe with knight on f3 or something like that. Even knight g4. But in f1, yeah, now queen b5. I don't know what's his idea. I guess he wants to go to e1. And now, I don't know if knight c6 or a5 immediately. And I don't like this king here, because just with the queen and a knight, I think black can create a lot of trouble. Yeah, queen b5 is being played. And after king e1, yeah, I think a5 is very annoying. Opening the b5 file for the queen. Yeah, okay, good news now for the Peru team. Maybe then we can try to get the victory. Also, we can see that Rundi is very low on time, just 25 seconds. So it's gonna be very difficult to defend, I think. On the other hand, I think Pranav is winning against Diego Saul Flores. Yeah, I think there is absolutely nothing to do, as I said, so it's gonna be the 2-0 for India. And Leon seems to be also winning now. Let's see what happened to play 25, but I think it's normal move, try to create some ideas. Even if it is not the best move, I like the Steven idea to create some tactics idea. Bishop h3, rook c2, bishop f5, and he blundered this queen e5, attacking the rook and attacking the bishop. And now black is completely lost. Yeah, he took here, takes, and yeah, now white is a queen up, as in the other game, just rook and bishop. It's not enough compensation for the queen. So again, winning position for the Indian team, for Leon Mendonca, and this is looked really really good for the Indian team, that I think is gonna win the title. And yeah, the only problem, as I mentioned before, can be the time, just 1 minute Leon, but I think it shouldn't be a problem. Even a draw, it's enough to secure the title, as Prague is it's not losing this game, it's winning or draw, probably a draw. And this position of Pranav is completely win. So yeah, Indian team very close to secure the victory. And let's see if Henry can get at least a consolation victory in this match. I think he's very close. Actually, now just take and knight c6 is winning a pawn. No matter how you do it. You take with the queen, knight c6, and one pawn is hanging with a winning ending. And if he plays, say, take before, it's the same, knight c6, and before cannot be defended. So, yep. I think it's gonna be a victory for Peru, for the Saco Libero team. And it seems like the score will be something like 1.5, 3.5, something like that. Yeah, Brad putting some pressure, 3-2. Well, so far, Bravo is defending well. Not doing anything strange, but still he will have to play for 20-30 moves because of course Black is not gonna give him draw yet. Yep, let's see Steven games. Yeah, Leon doing the same plan as we mentioned before. I think maybe it's not that easy to break the black position, but I think going slowly with this queen advantage could be victory sooner or later. Probably a good plan is just to defend everything, then try to look for this knight to go to a5 or d4, probably d4. And putting more pressure on c6, the queen can go to d6, which seems like a good square. And also at some point, b5 can be a threat, taking advantage that the group and the queen coordinates attacking c7. So after you play knight b3, b5 is gonna be a threat. Yeah, I think this is the plan for Leon. It's not difficult, but he has 30 seconds. If you don't know, the time control is it was 20 plus 10, so it's just 10 seconds increment, which makes it really difficult, actually. It's very hard to play with 10 seconds, of course. So still, I think everything can happen. Of course, it's very completely winning position. But without time, I've seen even worse position to. I think Henry's winning already. I don't know what happened here. I think he sacrificed everything time to be perpetual, but it's just not happening. 22, 21, and Black is just taking everything. King A3, and this is, I think, just like Queen C3. King A2, Queen B3, and Knight C2 mate. So yeah, victory for the Peru school here, for Saco Libero. Good game, but Henry Richard Vasquez. I really liked it, actually. It was a good example of how to play this kind of position. And I think white mistake was this before. I really don't like this move. I understand the idea is to avoid Knight A5, but with this before, this C4 square is gonna be weak for the rest of the game, and also A5 can go as we saw in the game. So really good game by Henry here. I think, as I said, a good example of how we play this kind of position. And so far it's 2-1 for Belamal Nexus, for the Indian team. They won the game. Pranav won that game with that we saw that was completely winning. And the rest, this game is still 2, still should be a draw. And this position we saw before, Leon playing slowly, improving his position before A4. As I said, some B5 should come At some point, not now, of course, because after takes and group C7, suddenly there is some trouble here. So, first to move the knight, and now there is some group before, so maybe F first, then knight B3, and then this idea would be bad. Try to avoid every counterplay. This is probably what he's thinking. And yeah, I would like to see F3, I think it's that's a good news. Hmm? Because the A4 square can be, it's very good square for the black pieces, no? The rook, also the bishop can go, and also the knight at some point. So I think F3 is very, very useful move, and it could show some class in my opinion. Yeah, I think without them, he's just trying to play some with the moves. We play queen h4 and go back to f4. I understand. It's, as I said, it's not easy to play with just 10 seconds, so playing too fast is more important. No, I think the only thing that matters here is just not to lose some time. So doing well. I think what's happened in this game, I think, just we have these two games left. So, the Indian team needs to score just 1 point in these two games, that seems actually very easy. If he doesn't lose some time, I think. Yeah, maybe he just wants to repeat playing some queen d4, queen f4, and just make a draw and win the match. I think that would be smart, because Prak is of course not gonna lose. Maybe he even will win, because this kind of ending it's always a draw, but it's not easy to defend in a rapid game, especially when you have 10 seconds increment. So. Yeah, it's rapid games, 10 second increment, someone is asking there. So yeah, just a draw from Leon would be securing the match for the Indian team. 24, knight d6, queen, knight a6, attacking c6. I'm putting a trick, no? After knight c4, that seems the idea, the rook c4. But if he takes, queen takes d8, but this is the idea. But there is rook e4. I don't know if he blunders this. I think that would be a bit scary, no? To see this with just 10 seconds. But unfortunately, Steven went for knight f5. I think knight c4 would have created some trouble for Leon, actually. Still knight f5, queen b2, and d4. Well, I think black is fighting very well here. Yeah. The score is 2-1 for India. White is winning in this game, but black is trying everything, I think, to fight. He takes, knight takes. Actually, black is getting some activity. Rook is entering only two. Knight is also getting 92 take and taking the rook. So actually, white has not to be careful now. I'm just 15 seconds. Let's see, because now the Peru team maybe has some chances. I mean, they really need to win this game. It's the only chance. And Steven is doing everything in his hand to make it possible. In h1, rook e2, he's taking on f2. Problems for Leon. Queen c3, rook takes f2. I think I changed that. Maybe I should do this. Rook f2, and now I don't know what is actually white smooth. Bishop e4 is coming. Queen e3, rook e2, bishop e4 is coming. Black is winning. Black seems to be winning. Maybe we can have tie breaks. I didn't expect this to happen, but I guess without time, as I said, everything can happen. Well, bishop e4 is coming, and black is completely winning now. So if black doesn't win, probably we have tie breaks. Let's see, but it seems now that we're gonna have tie breaks. Very unexpected, but very well played by the Peru team. He didn't play bishop e4, he played knight f5, which I didn't expect. With the idea of rook e2, it makes sense, but bishop e4 seems very strong. Now knight c5 back. And now I guess rook d2 is his idea. He didn't play yet, but I guess he will go for rook d2. Yep, already on the board. Now I think rook d1 has to be played because knight d4, rook d4 winning. So rook d1. Now it's not that easy. Okay, black plays rook f2. Yeah, I think that bishop e4 was very important. Now white managed to defend everything. I guess Steven is trusting his position in a possibly in a knight h4 move, threatening g2. But I don't know if it's gonna happen. Queen c7 and knight d4. Okay, I like this idea. Knight d2 can come. Also, if white takes on e7, very good idea. This knight f3. Taking advantage of the stake, it's just made with rook h2. So yeah, okay, he took on a7. Maybe knight f3 is now winning move, but it seems that it's not winning because knight e6 is coming, and actually black would be in trouble. So good move by Steven. Now bishop f5, avoiding knight e6, also avoiding knight e7. Leon goes for queen c7 again, avoiding this knight f3 idea because now the queen's defense h2. And this is madness. You know what is happening, knight d2. Let's take a look at my track games. It's still a draw, but maybe king h4 is now winning. If that wins, the Asian team wins the title, so it would be a pity because all the effort made by Steven would be not enough. Knight f4 on the board, knight e4, and bishop e4, and black is winning. Rook takes, rook f1, rook d2, and mate. Okay, Steven won this game for Peru's team, and now the score is 2-2. Yes, black teams is left, and yeah, it's still a draw, and I think in h4 is probably winning. He's thinking, I don't know if we have times correctly because 6 minutes seems a lot. I guess he just got a lot of time by playing fast. Yeah, king h4 is being played, rook g8, and according to the computer, the endgame is winning for black, but I'm pretty sure it's not easy at all. What's the idea to win this endgame? Because if you go with the rook, then white takes this pawn, and you cannot enter with the king. So probably the idea is to play king h3 and try to play rook g2 and take the pawn with the king. I think this is the winning idea for black. Let's see if black can win this game and give the title to India. Gonna be very close. Eh? It seemed like a Indian team was completely winning, but I really like how the Zach Oliveiros team fought for this match. Yeah, if someone is entering now the broadcast, the score is 2-2. And yes, this game is gonna decide everything. Black with the black pieces. Decent game, it seems to be winning, but still not easy. And he played rook d1, king h2, and rook d5, and as I said, the idea is to play rook d2, that it is not easy, even here, because you are, of course, giving the a5 pawn, but if the king gets to f3, game is over. So this is the idea. Let's see if he can find the rook d2 by Bragg. Very well played, and it seems that he's gonna win this game, and he's gonna gain the title. Yeah, rook takes c5, and now king d3, and I think game is kind of over. Rook d8, king takes f3, and okay, I think this is theoretical. I think Bragg is not gonna miss this. Yeah, of course, the drawing position is would be with the king on f1. With the king that far, Black is just gonna push the f pawn and it's gonna win. They are playing a bit fast now, but for sure Black is gonna win this end game. And finally, the favorite one, the Indian team, Belamal Nexus, is gonna be the world school chess champion. Let's see the game, chess 3. Check f2, and now this theoretical idea to put the rook here. Just play rook d7, just king d1, f1, and game is over. Okay, so well, let's wait for the game to end. But victory for Belamal Nexus. Indian team is the winner, and very well played by Bragg, that he won this theoretical draw ending 4-3 that we've been many times, but it's not strange that he won in a rapid game, because it's not easy to defend. And well, I think also we need to applaud the Peru team, because they did really well. They put a very good fight. And yeah, they even deserve this tie breaks. I think it was amazing how they fought in this match. And yeah, still I think it was of course deserved for the Indian team. They were better, I think, the whole tournament. And yep, I think we can end this broadcast now. Thanks everything for watching, and okay, see you next time.